In today's video, we're talking about how to go about planning your wedding reception seating charts. What should you consider when putting one together, and what to consider when putting which guests where. Welcome back to Newlyweds TV. If you're new to our channel, you should totally start by subscribing so you don't miss a thing. We're here as a guide for anyone planning a wedding right now, moving towards becoming newlyweds. I'm Leanne Valdez, the founder of You Name It Events, where we have been helping our clients plan meaningful, beautiful weddings for over a decade. Without a doubt, two of the toughest parts about planning your wedding involve your guests. The first is when you're actually deciding who to invite. Creating your initial guest list can be super tough, especially if you have any limitations on the total number of people you are able to include, which most people do. Whether your limits relate to your planning budget or the size of the space you plan on using or another factor, the bottom line is that it can be tough to decide who to include in your big day. Once you have that all figured out and you've sent your invitations, received your RSVPs back, the next big hurdle as it relates to your people is where to seat them all. There's an idea that couples sometimes have to let their guests choose their seats themselves. In my opinion, no matter how casual the vibe your wedding may be, this actually makes things tougher on the day of the wedding. For folks used to coming to weddings and having an assigned seat, it can cause some anxiety to not have a specific spot. Additionally, people don't naturally fill up every seat at each table. Think about whenever you go somewhere with groups and open seating, like the movies, for example. If we humans get to decide, we'll always leave a socially acceptable seat or two between ourselves and the nearest group. With open reception seating, people will also do this at your wedding dinner tables, and you'll end up with little holes all over the place. If you're set on having open seating, we recommend maybe having 30% extra seating to account for this part of things. Keep in mind, this is gonna mean a few extra centerpieces, extra linens, and this could cost you some money in a few categories. Open seating also may not be an option for you, depending on your caterer or meal style. Be sure to talk to those vendors before you move too far down that path. And don't forget, if you're liking what you're hearing so far, give us a like down below. On to some more strategies for seating your guests. Most people plan to seat their closest family and friends nearest to where they will be sitting, so those folks can have a great view. Consider nearness and loudness when seating your older guests. We often get complaints when they're seated too close to where the band or DJ will be set up because it's too loud for them. Plan to put your party people closest to your dance floor and or your bar. If your venue setup requires that tables be removed to create a dance floor after dinner, we suggest putting your younger folks who would perhaps spend their time on the dance floor anyway at those tables so they're less likely about worrying about being displaced. Think about getting creative with your table groupings. If you've got friends or family that you've always wanted to introduce or you think would hit it off, perhaps use their table assignment as a chance to connect them. What about a kids' table? Is this a good idea? Well, it can be if the kids are old enough to eat unattended and not cause any disturbance. For littler kids, they should probably be seated with their parents or another caretaker if they're invited at all. Hopefully these tips will help you as you work on seating your guests. If you want to learn about some DIY ideas you can do to save money on your own wedding, then watch the next video linked up on the screen. Remember, if you need more help, that's what us planners are for. Take care, and thanks again for watching.